Hello, you're watching DD News and I'm Preeti presenting this special edition tracking COVID-19 where we bring to you all the updates relating to the deadly virus that has left the world helpless with its outbreak. As a precautionary measure, Prime Minister Modi announced a 21-day lockdown of the entire nation to ensure that people stay indoors and social distancing, that is the best prevention aimed at disrupting the chain of transmission, is practiced by the people. We get you the latest updates on the measures taken by respective state governments to ensure the threat of COVID-19 is minimized, along with international updates on the pandemic. This and more in the next half an hour. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has greeted people on festivals, most of which mark the beginning of the new year, and said on this Navratra, he will pray for those engaged in combating coronavirus. In a series of tweets, he greeted people on Ugadi, Gudi Padwa, Navre and Sajibu Cheraba. In a tweet, he said, and I quote him, "We are celebrating various festivals across India and also the start of new year as per our traditional calendar. Greetings on Ugadi, Gudi Padwa, Navre and Sajibu Cheraba. May these auspicious occasions bring good health, happiness and prosperity in our lives. We are marking these festivals at a time when our nation is battling the COVID-19 menace. The celebrations will not be like they are usually, but they will strengthen our resolve to overcome our circumstances. May we keep working to fight COVID-19 together." Ministry of Home Affairs has issued guidelines of effective measures and details of availability of essential services during this 21-day lockdown. In his address to the nation, Prime Minister Modi announced nationwide lockdown for 21 days. The guideline says private offices, commercial and private establishments will remain shut. Factories, industries, transport services, that is air, rail, roadways, cab services will remain shut. Also, hospitality services, educational training, research institutions, religious places will remain closed. However, these are on your screens. These are the places, the services which will remain open: hospitals, dispensaries, clinics, banks, ATMs, public utilities, which include petrol pumps, CNG, LPG and gas pumps. And also, when we talk of shops, food, shops selling food, groceries, milk, fruits and vegetables will remain open. Police, home guards, civil defense, private security, fire and emergency services and also post offices will remain open. Print and electronic media, municipal bodies, that is electricity, water, sanitation, they will remain open. Also, delivery of essential goods will not be disrupted through e-commerce, warehousing, service, transmission units. Hotels, lodges and homestays will also be operational. All social, political, cultural, sports, entertainment, academic, religious and also organizations will remain open. Employers open must ensure social distancing, which is the crux word here. Also, any person violating these containment measures will be liable to proceed under legal action. Remember, funerals and congregations will not be allowed wherein more than 20 people have gathered, that is less than 20 people should be present at a gathering that has been allowed. Also, for unhindered supply of essential goods and services at ground, the Ministry of Home Affairs has asked the states to set up a 24/7 control room or offices with helplines at state and district level to address any grievance, undue problems faced by the providers of goods and services, including during interstate movement. The Delhi government has also issued guidelines for lockdown due to COVID-19 and also its containment. As the 21 days nationwide lockdown has begun from today, the interstate borders of Delhi with its neighboring states have also been sealed. In order to facilitate smooth and uninterrupted operation of the essential services, standard operating procedures have been issued by the government. The guidelines include, we have them on your screens, free movement in and out of Delhi with ID cards. And this is allowed only for employees of government units, PSUs, contractual and healthcare personnel, doctors, paramedical staff, lab technicians. Free movement of general public for allowed for procurement of essential commodities. Delhi residents stranded outside Delhi allowed to enter with valid ID or residence proof. Also, e-pass to be issued for people coming from outside Delhi by district magistrates. The applicants can apply for e-pass on WhatsApp or on the email ID, that is dtma.delhi@nic.in. A 24/7 control room will be monitored by Divisional Commissioner. The nodal officers at interstate border checkposts to be available 24/7 at all entry points of Delhi. Added to that, as we told you earlier also, these are the essential services which will remain open throughout the 21-day lockdown. Shops selling food items, groceries, milk, food, fruits, vegetables, animal fodder, cold storage, these will be operational. Municipal bodies will be operational. Electronic and print media will be operational. Also, activities related to functioning of Legislative Assembly of Delhi will continue. Pay and Account Office will continue its operations. Added to that, e-commerce services, banks, ATMs, public utilities, that is petrol pumps, CNG, LPG, gas retail outlets will remain open. Hospitals, dispensaries, chemists, pharmacies, clinics, laboratories will continue giving their services to the people. Takeaway or home delivery will be operational in restaurants. However, all right, the SEBI-regulated stock market entities and essential staff-related stock markets will also remain open. And the centre has asked state governments to deploy additional medical facilities and fiscal resources for fighting COVID-19. Let's take a look at the latest data regarding spread of coronavirus in India. Now, the total number of active cases of coronavirus has risen to 512. 9 deaths have been reported due to coronavirus in the country. 40 people undergoing treatment have been cured and discharged from the hospitals. The highest number of cases have been reported from Maharashtra and Kerala. 102 positive cases were reported from Maharashtra, while 109 cases were reported from Kerala. Tamil Nadu has recorded its first death due to the coronavirus outbreak. A 54-year-old man infected with the virus died at Rajaji Government Hospital in Madurai in the early hours today. The State Health Minister, C. Vijayabhaskar, said that the man had a medical history of prolonged illness with uncontrolled diabetes, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease with hypertension. On Tuesday, the total number of COVID-19 cases in the state rose to 18 after 6 more people, including 3 women, tested positive for COVID-19. And to get us more on that, our correspondent Philip Matthew is joining us. Philip, we've told our viewers that the total number of the cases of COVID-19 have risen to 18 in the state. Let us know the latest figures. Any change?
Well, as you just mentioned, Tamil Nadu has recorded its first death in the coronavirus outbreak. In fact, he was a man, a 54-year-old man, who had come into contact apparently with some tourists who had come down from Thailand. And in the process, he himself was infected. He was initially admitted to a private hospital and thereafter shifted to the Rajaji Government Hospital in Madurai. As you mentioned, he was a man with underlying health conditions. He was suffering from diabetes. He had pulmonary disease and hypertension as well. So the state health minister did indicate yesterday that his condition was critical, but that he was being carefully monitored. He said of all the cases under treatment, his was the case that was causing the most concern to doctors, and in spite of their best efforts, he passed away early this morning. So clearly, it is a bit of a setback for the state government, but the officials say that they are redoubling their efforts to ensure that all those who are being monitored are in good medical care.
Also, Philip, also let us know the current situation in the state after the 21-day lockdown, which had been announced by the Prime Minister. Tell us, how has the day begun today in Tamil Nadu?
Well, now that the Prime Minister has announced the lockdown, even prior to that, the state government had imposed Section 144, and in fact, they had announced lockdown on their own. So clearly, this is, in a sense, an extension of that. There is hardly any traffic on the roads except, of course, essential vehicles that are plying, vehicles carrying officials or police vehicles and ambulances. Otherwise, we don't see much traffic on the roads. Most people have chosen to stay indoors. Yes, provisions, stores, as well as shops supplying essential commodities are open. But, there were some reports of panic buying yesterday. But apparently, that has come down today. The state government has announced a package for the more vulnerable sections of society, and they promised free rations for both March and April. So, and they've also announced a dole of 1,000 rupees for all ration card holders. So clearly, the state government is also putting in its efforts to ensure that the lives of those at the most vulnerable sections are not put at risk. Apart from that, the state government is taking a number of steps to ensure that medical care system is in a position to cope with any outbreak. Most hospitals are now setting up separate wards for coronavirus patients. In fact, a major multi-speciality hospital, government hospital in Chennai, has now been designated as the nodal hospital for COVID-19 cases. In fact, the entire hospital has been converted into a hospital for COVID-19 patients. So, in other words, clearly the government, realizing the seriousness of the outbreak, is now ramping up its efforts to ensure that there are sufficient beds as well as equipment like inhalers and others available, so that ventilators, so that in case the number of cases go up, the state government would be in a position to deal with that. Apart from that, of course, the police have begun patrolling most areas of the city and the nearby towns and villages, in trying to ensure that people don't stay on the roads. They are, keeping a track on whether people are gathering in public places. Buses, of course, are not plying. Trains also haven't been plying for the last couple of days. So clearly, there is a sense of calm, but there is also a sense of unease, because people don't quite know whether the number of cases will multiply in the coming days or not.
All right. Thank you so much, Philip, for joining us with those updates. That was our correspondent, Philip Matthews, joining us from Tamil Nadu. Let's get to more updates from rest of the country. The supply of essential goods is normal in various states, including the Union Territories. Shops of essential goods, including milk and food, are open, and people are buying items of daily needs. And up next, we share with you visuals coming in from Lucknow. People are following the social distancing norm while they are out buying items of daily needs. And today's Navratri and prayers were offered in closed doors in Ma Durga temples. And Tapas is joining us from Delhi to get us more. Tapas, even as we speak, the 21-day lockdown is in progress all across the country. You're there in Delhi. Let us know, how has the day begun there in the national capital?
Yes, Preeti, and it is the start of a major lockdown that the Prime Minister Modi has announced yesterday. And keeping in mind all these things, the Delhi government, along with the district magistrates of district, have decided to form what you call civil defense group. And these civil defense group are there. They are providing the people explanation and idea of what needs to be done, what not to be done. There is a pamphlet that they have here, and they explain through this pamphlet. I'll show you right now what they explain through this pamphlet, the idea of what needs to be done here and what are the reasoning behind this. And Along with that, there is a lady here who is providing hand sanitizer to each and every person here who comes in, and also they stop people who are not who don't require to come out on the road. Now, the second part that is very important is these shops, these essential shops which sell items, day-to-day items, and they are open. There is a chemist shop which is also there, which is also open. So all these things are, you know, all the essential items, and they are open here in Delhi. And the government, the center, as well as the state government, are leaving no stone unturned to make sure that this lockdown can be, you know, it finishes off without much of an entrance, and whatever the solution needs to be that has to be placed in front of the people are placed. So these are some of the key decisions that have been taken. The civil defense group, which has been created, is working hard. The police on the road are working hard to make sure that you know, the people stay inside, and that is what the message is coming out from here. Because remember, social distancing is the key, and that is what is required to
all right, Tapas, what are you seeing on the roads? Because the Prime Minister just a couple of days back had given a stern word of caution, wherein he said that the lockdown was not being taken seriously by the people. And now we have the Prime Minister yesterday, when he announced the 21-day strict lockdown all across the country. What is it that you are witnessing on the roads? Are people adhering to this lockdown?
They are, but there are always those people who tend to play what you call the adventurous game. And for that, the police is there on the road, the defense group is there on the road, and they are making sure that you know, all these kind of people can be dealt with in a severe manner. There are people who first tell them that this is not something that you should do, and if they even then they try to move out of their house, they try to defy this lockdown. The police are there; they have been given all the powers to take these people in a much more harsher manner than anybody would have said. Now, going about, you know, if I can show you the visuals of the road, if I can show you the visuals there. If you see this visual, these are providing you the idea that there are people still on the road, but they have been stopped by these defense groups, and they have been told that they please stay inside, and if they are going out, they should have the mask, they should cover themselves, and they should provide themselves with the these sanitizers. So in fact, I just show you, this lady just now was stopping this. You can just see this lady is stopping a guard also. This place is mostly little with the apartments. Most of the apartments have come out with a self-isolation. They have shut their gates for anybody who can come inside. Even the maids, even the housekeeping staff have been told not to come inside. Whatever needs to be done, they will provide. So what I can tell you is that basic necessities of day-to-day life have been provided. But there's also this thing that there have been, the police and the executive decision makers have pointed out, that it is also up to the people to make sure that social distancing and self-isolation is followed. And if you are coming if you're coming from outside India, you should put yourself into isolation for the next 14, 15 days.
Pretty. All right. So all measures being taken to ensure that the threat of COVID-19 is minimized. Thank you so much, Tapas, for joining us from Delhi. Up next, we'll go across to our correspondent, Shyama, who's joining us from Mumbai. Shyama, we had our correspondent Tapas telling us that in Delhi, people are out on the roads, but to buy items of daily needs. You're there in Mumbai. Tell us, how is the day faring? How is the lockdown, in fact, faring there in Mumbai?
People behind me, they are walking out on the street and to buy essential commodities, because we know for the fact that Maharashtra is celebrating Gudi Padwa, the festival of New Year, and that is why the reason that they have to come out is to buy essential items. You can see here that the fruit vendor is also selling the fruits. We inquired with him. He did mention that, you know, he's asking people to keep social, to maintain social distancing. And when more people are coming, he is the one telling people ki ekdam pass mein aake aap mat kariye. And we also asked him about the prices and about the the kind of products that he's selling. He did mention that there is some difficulty in new products that are coming in, but the prices are in proper range and he's not extra charging anybody. Here you can see, I'm showing you the visuals of a marketplace where the essential commodities like the onions and potatoes and also tomatoes, these little shops are open because people need to buy their essential commodities. And like yesterday, asked people not to do panic buying. People have refrained from that, and that is the reason that they are coming today in the morning and purchasing stuff. We also did see in the morning that the milk shops, they were open. Some shops having groceries, they were also open. But they did say that, by the time it's 11:30, 12, they would be shutting shops because they would be keeping it open for the entire day because they are also participating in the lockdown and the curfew because they also know that keeping distance and, not keeping it open will only help in the, social distancing and thus by not spreading the virus.
All right, Shama, thank you so much for joining us with those inputs from Mumbai. So we had our correspondents joining us from different parts of the country telling us more about how the lockdown is being followed by the people in different parts of the country. People are out but to buy essential items of need, of daily needs. And more or less, the lockdown is being followed by the people across the country. We'll keep you updated. But also, in other news, in the backdrop of the outbreak of COVID-19, numerous measures are being taken by the government to give relief to the workers. The Labour and Employment Ministry has issued an advisory to all states and union territories for the usage of cess fund for welfare of construction workers. Union Food Minister Ram Vilas Paswan said that the government is monitoring the availability of essential commodities in the market amid nationwide lockdown for the next 21 days to check the spread of coronavirus outbreak. Paswan warned manufacturers and traders against profiteering during this period. The centre is also in touch with the state governments to ensure that there is no shortage of essential commodities. In a tweet, Paswan said, and I quote him, "In view of the situation emerging from the threat of COVID-19 in India, the government is keeping an eye on availability of all essential commodities in the market. I appeal to all manufacturers and traders to avoid from profiteering in this situation." And up next, we'll give you a quick look at how the world is faring when we talk of COVID-19, the outbreak of the COVID-19. When we up next in our graphic plate, we'll get you country-wise confirmed cases and the deaths. In Italy, 63,927 cases have been reported. 600 deaths have come to the fore. In China, 81,747 confirmed cases and 3,283 deaths have been reported. When we talk of Europe, France, Germany, 19,615 cases reported from France with 860 deaths, and 29,212 cases reported from Germany and 126 deaths. Also, when we talk of Spain, 33,089 cases and 2,182 deaths have been reported. And Iran, out of 23,049 confirmed cases have been reported from Iran and 127 deaths have been reported from there. And up next, we get you some ways through which we can help the society in times of the pandemic. Stay home. Remember the saying, home sweet home. With that, we'll take leave of you. Thanks for watching. Namaskar.